Welcome to Absolute Match Fishing. My name's Matt Godfrey and today you join me on a beautiful stretch of the Warwickshire Avon at Severn Meadows. This particular stretch of water is controlled by Stratford and District AA and it's full of all kinds of different species of fish. We could catch some big bream, some barbel, chub, anything could happen. To do the business, I've brought along two flowing water experts, Michael Buckwelder and Scott Jeans. I'm dead excited to see what they catch and hopefully they'll show us some tips and bits of advice to help you catch marfish on rivers. I'm here with the lads right now. Good morning, gentlemen.
How are you, sir?
Not bad, not bad. Nice to morning, see mate. You both. What a beautiful stretch of river this is, eh?
It's gorgeous.
Absolutely beautiful. What fishing's all about for me.
I wish I were fishing today. I envy both of you, but unfortunately I'm not. Anyway, time for the all-important draw. As always, a little bit different to normal. I've got some maggots in my hand today. And I want you two to guess what colour they are. They could be bronze or they could be red. Whoever wins the right colour gets the choice of pegs. I've got two stunning looking swims, one just above a weir with a nice reed bez opposite and one a little bit further up with some trees and plenty of shade. They both look nice pegs, but someone's got to pick. So are we having bronze or are we having red?
Shall I go first?
Yeah, go on then, age before beauty.
Normal river colour, bronze maggots I'll go for.
Leaves you with red, Michael.
So yeah, that's all right.
I can reveal they are bronze, so Scott, you've got the choice of swims. Which one are we having?
Predictably, I'm going for end peg above the weir.
Oh, I think I'd have picked that one.
I'll take what's left.
Well, I'm looking forward to seeing what you're both going to do. I'm sure we'll catch plenty of fish and you'll reveal some of your little river tricks along the way. So, come on, I'll give you an hand to get set up. Let's go.
Let's go.
Not long before the start of the match now. I'm just having a walk up to see Michael before he kicks off. They're both about ready to go. Scott's going to start his match by really attacking the swim. He's got some big balls of ground bait. He's going to make some noise, bosh some baiting. Michael, on the other hand, I think he's going to fish a feeder to start with. He might sneak an early bream to give him a lead, but I'm off to shout the all in now. This is it, folks. We're just a few seconds before the start of the match. I'm stood behind Michael and he looks just about ready to go. All in! I'm here with Michael and he started on the feeder. He's had a few early fish and he's into another one now. What we got, Mike?
This is a little perch, Matt, that's all. Wrapped itself around a bit of a branch.
Chunky little character though, him, isn't he?
Yeah, soon add up, don't they, them ones?
Yeah. What have you had him on, Mike?
I had him on a bit of worm, Matt, that's all. A bit of worm, about an inch long.
Lovely stuff. You got a little ground bait feeder on there, yeah?
Yeah, you swallowed it right down. Little bit of worm, inch long.
Greedy little things, them, aren't they?
You don't miss a bite, do you?
No, no. Let's have a look at your rig before you chuck him back out, Mike. You want to talk us through it from bottom
just
end?
Got a size 16 hook on. Nothing too exciting, really. Tied sort of, was it 0.015, mate, back hook length. Then going to a 6-pound line straight through to my reel with a little 4-bar. Open feeder.
Very nice, what nice and simple. And you've got a little paternoster on there, haven't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, yeah, just find a paternoster better fishing for bream as opposed to on a loop, maybe a loop on a fast river, but not today, not here.
Right, and quite a long hook length, I know.
Always start
well.
Long, yes, yeah, sometimes start longer than that. Just
what's
the fact.
That? Sort of 3 foot there?
Yeah, 3.5 foot, isn't it? It's got to be 3.5 foot.
And what's the reason for that, Mike?
Just I think the first sort of hour or two, they sort of back off, they put the feed in, and they seem to sit back and come up the peg at it, really. So I think by targeting the bottom of the peg first, I can always go shorter if I need to be, just cut it off and tie the hook on a foot above it again. It's not an issue. It takes 2 seconds to tie a hook on. But to add it on, you've got to take it all apart, put a new hook length on.
So the idea, start nice and long, catch them few fish that are backing off, and then gradually as they
yeah,
start
to... Yeah, because generally on a commercial, we chuck it and they come to a splash, don't they?
Yeah, yeah.
But on a river, you generally got to work your peg for a couple of hours before you get a bite. But today we've had a couple of early fish, but I don't expect to catch a bream for 2 hours or so.
I reckon you're going to get one next shot. Come on.
Hopefully we've got a bit of your luck, Matt. We might do. Let's put a big dirt snake on.
I notice you change your upbaits a lot, don't you, Michael?
Yeah, I always do. Until I find what's working. I always try and just experiment a bit. First hours on a river, unless you're on a shed full, is normally a throwaway hour, isn't it?
Find out what they want and then...
Like I say, if there's a big perch there or chub there, he's going to have that pretty soon, you think.
I wouldn't give that long.
I'd only give that maybe a minute and a half. A lot of time when I'm fishing the feeds, like changing baits, I count down from 90, start at 90 and finish at zero and reel back in.
Down and joined Scott, and he's into a fish straight away. But you've had a bit of a nightmare start, mate, haven't you?
Yeah, well, I've hooked a bream on a light rig early on, and unfortunately, it's done me.
Oh no!
But there's a few fish there, mate. I think that's a nice rod. You'd settle for catching one of them every chuck, wouldn't you?
Proper river fish, isn't it? That?
Yeah.
Let's have a look at him. Every fish is pristine condition.
Probably never seen the hook before.
Beautiful fish. You caught him on maggots, Scott, I take it?
Yeah, just on a double maggot.
That were a lovely fish, Scott, that roach. If you could just talk me through your rig before you ship back out, we can see what you're actually using there.
Yeah, fairly simple rig, Matt. Round body float, 1 gram, 8.5 foot water, about perfect.
Right.
Nice bit of pace on him. Olivet, about 2 foot from the hook. And I've got 5 number 10s just... sort of
equally spaced.
Well, sort of increasing slightly in the distance apart as you get near the hook. Sort of 6 inch hook length and 18s hook, diameter 9 bottom.
So I take it you're using quite light lines there, aren't you? An 09 hook length, that's sort of 1.5 pound, 2 pound. And you're fishing for small fish on this rig, or?
This is what I call my catch everything rig. I mean, 09 is it's quite a strong line. You'd be surprised, or people would be surprised, what you can actually get out on 09.
Right.
You know, you'll get out, although I've lost one bream, but I've, you know, you'll get a bream, a big roach, a big perch.
Sort of a really versatile hook length.
Yeah, coupled with like a number 5's elastic. It's like my all-round rig.
Lovely stuff. And them few droppers will give a nice slow fall in that last important bit. And
yeah, I always like to sort of start with 6 droppers. Well, I said if I've got 5, but I've got another one tucked under the olive up there. And then what I can do, that's so versatile, I can group that up into sort of, if I need more positive droppers, I can have 3. Double shot if you like.
Yeah.
You know, or I can spread it out even further. Just really, really versatile.
That's a great little tip, isn't it? Rather than having a few big shots, have lots of little shots and you can do more with it.
Yeah, so, exactly.
Lovely little river tip there. Go on, let's get back out. I want to see you catch one.
Let's get another one of them big roach, I reckon, mate.
What's made you fish that far out, Scott, today? Why have you chose to fish sort of middle of the river just there?
All I've done, what I always try and do when a river is get into the where that you've got the most flow.
Right.
And that's pretty much where the most flow is, right down the middle, it's at 13 metres. You know, if you look in front of you here, it's sort of, you know, slack water. And roach particularly, as well as chub, dace, you know, they're going to be in that flow.
Going all right so far, but we just hooked a bream, just swam straight into a snag. So one of them things I'm afraid I should keep solid. And we've lost him. It was going all right, but Scott's down there, a bit further to my right, and I'm hoping he's struggling. I've had 3 bream, a couple of skimmers, and a few eels, so at the moment it's all good. I'm just hoping Scott's got a few small fish and no big fish at the moment. But there you go, bent hook, never mind.
Michael's got off to a great start on the match. He started on the feeder, caught a few small fish and gradually built his peg up. In the second hour he's managed a couple of bream on it as well. However, he's now coming on his eel line on the pole, and this chap's got a bit of a reputation for catching these long slippery creatures. I'm going to go and find out how he does it now. Mr. Buckwelder. See that you're on your favourite eel method there.
Yeah, just got a bite now, Matt. Let's go in, it's going.
Oh,
there we go.
Yes, one on.
Nope, it's a skimmer.
Thought this were an eel rig.
Yeah.
You're not complaining though, are you?
Don't like to give too much away, you know me.
What have you actually caught on this so far, Mike?
Five or six eels, I think, Matt.
And now a brazine.
A bream that's rolled itself over the line. Look, best way, don't fight.
Have a look at him, mate.
Is he pound and a half?
Good weight, builders. I don't think Scott's had any of them yet, so.
Long may that continue.
You're in good stead. What are you actually fishing for the eels with?
Well, I'm fishing a little tiny bit of dendrobina.
Just the head of the worm?
Just the head of a worm, yeah, literally. What's that, half, 3/4 of an inch long.
Right.
Nothing too complicated, nice and easy.
And you've got quite a little hook on there, haven't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, size 16 again.
So them eels, they don't have big mouths all
no,
the time?
No, if you look at an eel, the mouths are tiny, so when you get a bite, you've got to let it develop and that, but last thing you want to do, you notice with eels, you miss 4 or 5 bites before you hook a fish.
Yeah, I've noticed that, actually,
but,
yeah.
We'll try and get you one now.
Come on then. You're just fishing sort of nearly in the middle of the river there, aren't you? What's that, 13 metres
That's
out?
That's 13 metres, yeah, that is. Just lowering it in now. This rig's a little bit lighter than the one I started on, so.
Have you got much line on the bottom? I know eels are notorious for feeding right on the bottom of the river, aren't they?
I've got about 3 inches, that's all.
Right.
Nothing too much, just 3 inches of line on the bottom. If you fish too much on the bottom, you tend to get them really deep hooks and you never get any hooks back.
Yeah. So you've made a change onto the Waggler and into one straight away, Scott?
Yeah, well, the pole line went a bit iffy earlier, Matt, if I'm being honest. Bright sunshine today has not helped, I think. Although, you know, the water looks...
Nice little days.
Yeah, the water looks reasonably coloured, but it is. It's clearer than you think. You know, so the roach that I'm catching, they backed off, little dace.
All little weight builders though, mate, aren't they?
Yeah, so...
What's the setup on the Waggler?
It's quite simple, really. So I've got a 3AA Waggler, just with a couple of number eights down the line. And a micro swivel as my last dropper.
What's that for, the swivel, Scott?
Well, it acts as your last dropper, but the main thing it does, it stops your hook length spinning up. Especially
right,
when you're fishing
right.
Double maggot, it spins round, and quite often you'll have to change your hook length, and you know, it just saves time during a match, generally.
Yeah. That's a good little tip. You always use a swivel when you're fishing a waggler on a river.
Yeah, and the size of the swivel can vary depending on what size you know droppers you're using. That one's sort of equivalent to a size 8 or a 9.
Lovely stuff.
So,
double maggot on the
hook. Double maggot again. I'm catching little dice like that, bleak. We've seen an odd big chub top as well, so with that in mind, we're gonna persevere on this for a bit and
a Chevin, as Isaac Walton referred to him as. One just had a little go at your maggots then, Scott.
Yeah, I think there's some fish there moving now, to be honest. It's just, you know, we caught a few more fish on the pole. We got a bream and a couple of eels, but we were definitely not going to catch a white or roach on it. So it's just about mixing it up and trying to keep putting fish in the net, basically.
And this waggler line's obviously, it's just past your pole line on that bit of flow going towards them weeds up there.
Yeah, I mean, I'm fishing like well off the bottom at the minute, but if it does get down to them weeds, it shallows up. And, you know, we're just fishing through the water, you know, probably 3.5 foot deep, a couple of foot off bottom maybe at the minute.
Do you tend to catch chub on rivers off the bottom, Scott? Is that a...
Yeah, quite often. I mean, on the real red letter days, you might, you know, you might get them a couple of foot deep. You know, sometimes you'll see them swirl when you feed the bait. I mean, we've had some small fish swirl today, but, you know, I think they're mainly bleak and little dace, little chublets maybe, but there'll be an odd crop running amongst them. There always is. It's just sorting them out, that's the problem.
You'll do it. I'm confident in you. That one looks like an eel, mate. The old shaking of the head.
Is. Here comes a snake.
The river snake.
Quite even being good for us.
Oh, you spoke too soon.
I opened my mouth. Netting these eels, you've got to go behind them and then come up behind them.
Get the tail first, yeah?
Yeah.
Slippery characters.
Never know when they're beaten, ever.
How big's that one, Mike?
It's a pound. Okay, we might not.
Not so good at the minute. I think Bud's stole a march on me. He's caught some better fish. I've changed tactics to a waggler, which has caught some fish. But I've caught an odd better fish on the pole early, so now I've reverted to the pole with a different rig, the flat float. Bait dropping in some chop worms and casters. We're fishing for big fish to try and pull back the lead. I've got a bream and a couple of eels, so it's worked, but we're definitely going to need some more fish. Another couple of bream maybe, or a tench, if I'm going to catch him. So we've got about an hour to go, so anything can happen. A few big fish, and he might not have it in the bag yet.
Nice rod, mate.
Don't catch many of them on the river, do you?
You don't. You've got to be good to catch them, haven't you?
Definitely got to have your rig right.
Ginger air helps as well.
I think it's a must.
Slipping back. We're not far off the end of the match now, and I can tell you what, it's been a really good day's fishing. One of the lads, Michael, has had a really exciting day. He's caught loads of different species of fish. He's caught some bream on a feeder to start with, some big eels on the pole. He's caught little fish, perch, an odd skimmer. He's been on a real aquarium of a peg, and we're going to see his net of fish in a short space of time. Scott has had things a little bit more difficult. I don't think there's been as many fish in front of him, but he's still managed to winkle out a big bream, and he's been catching a few bits and bobs, and he might just have a little bit more than we think, but there's not long left, and I'm going to shout the all out in just a few seconds. All out! Time to weigh Mr. Buckwelder in now. Come on, Michael, bring him up. Sure you don't need a crane to lift that lot out.
Normal down the Avon for me.
Well done, mate. Look at that.
What
a superb bag of fish on a river, eh?
How many different species are in there?
No, I've got one left. Can't miss.
Oh! Oh! That'll make all the difference, he will.
Better to be in the net than not.
Too right. Go on, have a wild guess, mate.
27.3.
26 pound, 9 ounces.
Well done, far away.
Awesome performance.
Absolute cheers,
pleasure watching you today. That's
them.
Cracking bag of fish. Must be 7 or 8 different species in there, mate.
Yeah, I think there's 16 or 17 eels. Three bream, a skimmer, some big roach. Now roach is now in a pound.
Lovely fish.
Well, these things, proper fish, aren't they?
Your favourites.
I love them.
Brilliant bag of fish, mate. Well, you slip them back and we'll go and weigh Scotty.
No problem.
Come on, Scott. There's not that many. You've not got a trip.
What happened there, then? I think I might have been on the wrong method for part of the day.
Still a nice little bag of fish, mate, that, from a river.
Well, I have caught 2 rudd. I think 2 rudd beats 20 pound every day of the week.
I did have 2 rudd as well, though, and a pound.
Sorry, 3 rudd.
Okay, you win.
And there's a little bit more than you were admitting to anyway, Scott, there.
Oh, it's going down.
I'm going to give you £7 exactly.
Wonderful.
Well done, mate. Not a bad net of fish, which means, Michael, you are the champion with your 26 pound, 9 ounces. Well done, mate.
Might have made the wrong decision on the peg.
Well, I don't know, mate.
I think it might just be better than me.
A lot of people would be proud of that bag of fish from a river. So,
yeah, nice.
I think it's well deserved, but I've certainly learned a lot, and hopefully, next time you're out on a river, you can put what you've learnt today into practice. We'll catch you next time on Absolute Match Fishing.